Hello, welcome to this week's edition of the talk show. I remain Elijah Ho Tanimola. Since the beginning of this month, I've been dealing with the intimacy series, and I trust that you have been blessed so far from the previous episodes. Today, I'll be talking on the subject, how to secure deep intimacy with your man. How can you enjoy a feeling of deep connection with your husband? A lot of women have been wondering, how can I achieve this? How can I attain this? Today, I'll be giving you some very, very important tips on how to achieve this, and I trust that this will transform your marriage. This will bring you into the reality of what you so much desire and God's ideal for your marriages and for your relationships. Secure deep intimacy with my man. The first thing you need to understand is that the gateway to your man's heart is through his primary gender need. When you understand the primary gender need of a man and you are ready to meet that need, you have access into his heart. You have access into the core of his heart, into the depth of intimacy that you so much desire and you need. And I want you to understand that sex is not the gateway to a man's heart. This is one of the major assumptions that many people have had over the years. Single ladies, they believe that if I give him sex, if I do all the styles for him and I'm doing all the gimmicks in bed and I try to up my sex game, I try to use Kayamata and other things to get him to be attracted to me, I can get into the core of his intimacy. But I'm telling you, you can never get to that core through sex. Sex to a man is simply an external act. It's more or less like a physical exercise to him. It's more or less like a task to him. So the moment when he sees you as a task, as a sexual task, he goes after you. And when he finishes that task, that's over. And that is why a man can be sexually involved with a woman and yet not sexually intimate with her. That is, sexual intimacy is not the same as sexual involvement for a man. And this is what we must understand, that the access to securing the major access to a man's heart and to securing the deep intimacy with a man is through his primary gender need. And what is his primary gender need? His primary gender need is simply work. I mean work, purpose, vision, project. He is energized by work. A man is a work being. He's not just a sex being. You know, a lot of people believe that men love sex than women, but I'm telling you, I can't even figure out who loves it more. The other thing is that a man is easily aroused than a woman. However, what men interpret as sex is not the same as what women interpret as sex. I said earlier that sex is simply an external act to a man. If you want to access the deep core of a man, you need to access his mind. And how can you access his mind? You need to understand that he's a work being. Understanding this primary gender need gives you real access to him. You know, the point is, we can actually trace this to the creational specification. When God created man, the first thing that God introduced to man was work. Not relationship, not family. In fact, it got to a point that man was so obsessed with work that he didn't even recognize that he needs relationship. He didn't even recognize that he needs family. It took God to say, no, it is not good for this man to be alone. I must make for him an helper. And you know something? God didn't just say, I will make for him a suitable helper. He said, I will make for him a suitable woman. He said, I will make for him a suitable helper. What does that imply? God is saying that if you want to get close to this man, you need to be an helper. Because his primary gender need is work. His primary gender need is purpose. So how can you access him? How can you get close to him? You need to be an helper. You need to be a support helper. You need to support him in what he's doing. That is how to access him. Most of the time, men only bring to their inner circle those who are interested in their work, those who are involved in their purpose, those who are involved in the project that they are doing. Don't ever think that you can secure a man's commitment through sex. I know some of you have tried it and you have seen the result. You have given him everything sexual, every style that you can ever think of, including the ones that have never, you have invented even the ones that nobody has ever known. And yet, he's not committed. And yet, he seems so far from you. That is because sex cannot get access into his heart. Sex to him is just an external heart. It needs to flow from the mind to his emotions. Then it overflows into sexual intimacy. That is when you can say that you are feeling a sense of connection with your man. Also, a lot of people believe, oh, if you fail to give him sex, he will be committed to marry you. I'm telling you, if you fail to, I'm not saying, I'm of the opinion that we honor God with our bodies and we keep ourselves to marriage. But I'm telling you, if you use sex as a bait to get a man to marry you, I am telling you, he will only see you at the task. It's just that the task is taking longer time. So he will go after you because you want sex, because you are using that sex as a bait to get him to marry you. He can even marry you, put a ring on the finger, and yet that is all. Once he gets done with you that night, that is all about it. Then you see so far away from him. You know why? You have not accessed his call. You have not get deep access into his call. Do you understand that when God created man, man was eager to do work. God brought all the animals to him. He quickly named them. There was no struggle. He is obsessed about work. But the moment God is saying, I will bring him a suitable helper, it's not a relationship, it's primary gender need, it's not family, it's not relationship really. The only thing that can make him to be interested in family and relationship, it is if that relationship and that family life is very important and significant to helping him to achieve success in his work and purpose fulfillment. So what I'm saying in essence is this. If you want to secure deep intimacy with your man, you need to make him see that his relationship with you is significant to fulfilling his purpose. That is how to secure his commitment. When a man sees that his relationship, his marriage, is important, is significant to enabling him achieving success in his work and purpose fulfillment, he is committed. Securing his attention is true fulfilling his primary gender need. You know, at a point, after Jesus Christ was grown at the age of 30 and he stepped out into his ministry, there was a point that his mother and his brothers came where they was teaching people in the house, and they said, your mother and your brother wants to see you. Jesus Christ said, no, who are my mothers and my brothers? He said, those who are here, those who are listening to me, what he's saying in essence is, those who are involved in my work, those who are involved in my purpose. And you know what? That woman was smart. She didn't take that as an offense. She processed that and she got involved in that ministry. Until the dying moment of Jesus on the cross, that woman was there. She accessed his inner circle by getting involved in his work. How can you secure a deep intimacy with your man? Recognize and understand this gender need. When you recognize and understand this gender need and you are involved in it, then you are securing deep intimacy. You are getting access into his core. You are getting access into his heart. You are getting access into the place of deep connection. Don't be angry that he's obsessed about work. That is his primary gender need. That is what we are built for. We are built for work. That was the first thing God introduced to us. So primarily, that is what we'll think about. You see, you don't need to be angry about his work.
You don't need to complain about his work. Just find a way to understand him that this is his primary gender need. Then the other thing you need to do after recognizing and understanding this is for you to be interested and involved, genuinely involved in that work. A lot of single ladies, before they get married, they are interested. They ask their husband, how was work today? How was that project? How is that vision you are thinking about? That vision you are executing, But when they get into marriage, suddenly they don't ask anymore. They don't show interest anymore. You know what? You don't use that as a bait. When you use that as a bait, the moment he sees that you are using this as a bait, that is the only time you ask for about his work, about what he's doing, is when you need something from him, when you need to meet a selfish need. He may be noble enough to give you anything that you need, but I'm telling you, he will not be able to bring you close to his heart, to the core of his intimacy, even if he wishes to. Because he cannot just do it. He is a work being. People that are interested in his work, they are people that have access to his inner circle. That is how it works. Another thing is this. How can I secure deep intimacy with my man? No, don't just be interested in his work. Don't just be involved in his work. Never see that work as a rival. A lot of women, they say, you have to choose between me and my work. You have to choose between me and your work. No, it doesn't work. It's a work being. Figure out how you can be involved in that work. It is not difficult. It could be something as simple as asking him about his day's work. It could be something as simple as preparing his luggage for that trip, for that business trip, for that work trip. That shows that your peace is going with him. It could be as simple as reminding him of what he says he wants to do pertaining to his work. It shows that you are thinking about his work. You are not just thinking about yourself. That is the involvement. It could be as simple as that. It is not something that needs to be overthought. I'm not saying that you leave your career and join his career. What I'm saying in essence is be interested, be genuinely interested, be genuinely involved in what he is doing. In his work, in his projects, in his vision, in his purpose. That is what gets you close to his heart. Another thing you need to understand is this. You must always make yourself available as a relief to his work, not as a burden. He's thinking about a project and yet you are giving him trouble in the house. How can you secure that intimacy? How? It cannot work that way. Someone said, it is either you are a prayer partner or you are a prayer point to the man in his purpose, in the fulfillment of his purpose. A woman that is a prayer point is a burden that he has to carry every time. When he's praying, he's worried. When he's at work, he's worried. When he's doing anything, he's worried because he has not been enjoying peace from you. Don't be that. Don't be a cross that he has to carry. Be a crown that he has to cherish. And he can only cherish you. He can only cherish you and nurture you the way that you want him to when you are deeply involved, interested, and providing relevant support and help in his work. That is the way to go. That is the way to go. That could be the little thing that you need to access his heart. You have been doing every other thing. You have been respectful. You have been trying your best. You have been making yourself available for sex. You have been trying to be creative in bed. You have even been trying to initiate sex a lot of times, and he appreciates that. But I'm telling you, it seems so far because you have not treated, you have not hit the core of his primary need, the primary gender need. You have not hit that core. When you start doing this, you are hitting the core. What else can I do to secure this intimacy? Always, always, always be the clarity. Always try to make yourself available as the clarity he needs whenever he's doubtful about any decision, especially work decisions. Maybe your husband is doubtful. Oh, should I take up that project? What should I do about this project? What should I do about this person at my place of work? Be ready to give him clarity about his doubts. A lot of time, my wife provides this for me. Sometimes I want to send a text message, or I want to write something to someone, I want to send a reply. I will say to my wife, please read it through. And sometimes, most of the time, she read it through and say, oh, why can't you change this statement? It sounds so harsh. It sounds so this. And I try to look at it and I try to figure out. And most of the time, in fact, if not all the time, those changes have been critical to making sound decisions and better decisions that I do not have to regret it. When you provide this kind of support, your husband will be closer to you. You will feel a sense of connection to him. You will feel a sense of intimacy. You will get into his heart. You will get access into the core of his being. And this implies, it simply means that you don't just have fine face and sexy body. You need to develop fine sense and God sense. It's not just about having fine face and fine body. You can get that anywhere. But you need to develop fine sense, God sense. If all you have is the fine face and the sexy body, all it will be seen about you is the sex and the glamour. You won't get access into his core. That is what you need. Then another thing, how can I secure deep intimacy with my man? How can I achieve this reality? Come into this reality that I so much desire. Don't just be involved in it. Don't just be interested in it. Don't just provide clarity to his work. Don't just be a relief to him. Give him peace. When a man knows that he's returning to a peaceful home, it relieves his stress. It enhances his work and it improves his commitment into that marriage. Don't make the home to be hell for him. Some men cannot just return to their homes. After the day's work, they are burdened, so burdened because their wives are not giving them peace. Be the peace that is so much desire. Be the peace that is so much required. And that will help your home. That will build the genuine intimacy that you require from your husband. If everything is all for him outside, ensure that your home is a haven of peace. Make the home heaven on earth for him. So much that he is willing to always come back home. He is willing to always be with you. Is that not what you need? Is that not what you crave for? Is that not what you desire? It's as simple as that. I believe that if you can create this atmosphere, you will get more intimate with your husband. You will get more closer connection with him. Then I want to share something, what I call the Big Bang application. The Big Bang application to accessing the core of your husband, to securing deep intimacy with your husband. Try to do this. Try to channel your support and your help for his work, for his purpose, for his vision, for his project through his primary love language. Last week I talked about love languages and intimacy. If the love language of your husband, for instance, is acts of service, be involved. You can just be involved in taking care of his laundry, the drop off and the pick up. And something as simple as that. If it's acts of service, you can be involved in trying to remind him of his activities. It's acts of service. If his primary love language is quality time, give him time, give him ear, listening ear to hear what he wants to say about his work. Sometimes he's so much burdened and he wants to pour it out. Be the listening ear. Try to push out the things in his heart to tell you. Sometimes you may not know that singular attention could be what will save your home from an impending danger. Because sometimes someone is getting too close to him in his place of work, and that could be the temptation that he might fall for and destroy your home. But when you pay attention to him, you are interested in his work, not as a bait, but as a lifestyle, then he is ready to open up to you, and that is what will secure a deep intimacy with him. If his primary love language is word of affirmation, you could just send a love card to him, writing how much it means to you. You can give him, you can send a text message. You can do a voice note. And very importantly, even if it's not his primary love language, always, and I say again, always tell him how important, how you value and appreciate what he's doing for you. Always affirm that. Even if he's giving you little, even if the dividend of that work is just little at this moment, always appreciate what he's doing. Always appreciate his value. Always appreciate his effort at ensuring there's peace in your home and there's prosperity for you. It doesn't have to be something big before you start appreciating. Appreciate the little things. That encourages him to do more. Don't always complain about what he gives to you. Always appreciate that he's trying. He's a work being. He's not naturally lazy. He's a work being. So he wants to work. So don't frustrate him. Appreciate. Always do that. Even if it's not his primary love language, that should be a rhetoric for you. Tell him, oh, that sermon was powerful. Oh, I enjoyed it. Even if you don't enjoy it, just to encourage it. Then later you can say, oh, baby, I think you should do more. I think you should. There's some areas that I feel you could have done better. But nevertheless, you tried your best and I'm there with you. You know, that is an encouragement for him. It's a word of affirmation that he needs to fire up and to continue. To always do better. If his primary love language is receiving gifts, you can give him, you can send him a creamy cup of coffee. You can also buy a coffee. Just maybe he's going for a special outing on a special trip, or he's going for a major keynote speaking engagement. You can buy him a special coffee. Say, oh, this is the token of my love and support for what you do. I believe in you. What? That is absolutely amazing. That could be what you need. That could be the big bank that you need. And if his primary love language is physical touch, you could be the relief that he needs. After a day's work, you take off his coat, his suit, you take his bag, you hug him, you kiss him, you hold him in a way that shows that is assuring and reassuring. That I believe in you, that I believe in the progress you are making, that I believe in a brighter future for both of us. Hold him in that way. And sometimes, if his primary love language is physical touch, it could be sex. You get it? When he's nervous, maybe he's going for a major speaking engagement, or he's going to present a particular, to defend a particular contract or whatever, and he's nervous and he's feeling anxious and things like that, you could initiate a spontaneous sex. Creative. Make it a time bomb. I mean, make it special. It doesn't have to be long to be special. A man doesn't need so much long time in sex. Just make it a special thing, a spontaneous thing, a creative thing. It could be in the bathroom. You could just be taking his back and you know his bed, preparing for that assignment, and you know that he's obviously nervous. Just enter the bedroom together. Give him a good sex. You get it? That could be what will fire him on. Because sex releases a stress and a love hormone. You get it? Those hormones, maybe those things that singular act of sex could be what he needs to fire on and to be more courageous to do, to give his best. As I said earlier, if a man can see that his relationship, that is you as a woman, as his wife, as his family, is significant to achieving success and fulfilling purpose, he will get more committed to you. And that commitment will be more lasting than you can ever think. I trust that you have been blessed by this episode. I am so assured that if you practice these things and you follow through, you have testimonies. You're on your way to enjoying God's ideal for your relationships, for your marriages. And this is the secret to accessing and to securing deep intimacy with your man and with your husband. Next week, I'll be coming with the other part. I'll be talking on how to secure deep intimacy with your woman, with your wife. And I trust that you don't want to miss that. Thank you for joining me tonight. God bless you. Stay safe and bye for now.